So what we're doing here, guys, is we're looking over McDavid and MacKinnon's head movement. So one thing that was brought to my attention by Mason Baptista, if you guys, he's a Train 2.0 member, and he's part of the what he has is BAPS Hockey, and he was part of the pro camp last week. And so he was talking to me about, he works with these guys called functional patterns. And they pointed out to me that when Usain Bolt runs, and like any high-level sprinter runs, there's actually a distinct side-to-side head movement. And I've been like totally exploring that for the past few days. if you had a camera on me while I was walking down the street, it would, you know what, there's probably already some compilations of that out there, me walking around. But what I want you to see is like, just pay attention to how far Usain Bolt's head moves laterally. So that's like a starting point on that stride. And then notice how it moves to there. And then it moves back, right? And then it moves over again. Okay, so there's this like bobbing and weaving as the head goes side to side. Now we looked up, we're looking at, okay, like, does this apply to hockey? And if you look, right, you can watch with McDavid too, especially when he gets cooking at top speed. This isn't like a perfect view of it, but you can really see how much his head goes from one side, and then you guys can see how the camera's tracking, so it's not good. But you can see where his head is right here, right there, and then what you'll notice is how the head shifts to the other side of the body, right? So you actually see there the lateral head movement, which is kind of crazy. You can see this here with MacKinnon as well. So what I want you to pay attention to is his head movement here. Like, that's where it starts, and then notice how it moves across to here, and then it moves back to here, and then it moves again to there. Now, like, what's the deal with all this head movement? And like, why is this, what's going on there? Like, why am I all of a sudden talking about head movement? Should we all be like bobbing our heads around? Like, I thought ankles was the thing, and it is. But you know, this is an opportunity just to like really dissect movement and like look at what's going on here. And this is going to build into like your rhythm and your cadence and that kind of thing. So the main thing to get is that when the head is over on this side, like over here, this hip actually ends up being like tilted this way. And what it does is it creates like a stretch across here, and then it creates like a bowing across here. And like Mason and I talking about this was just, you know, strength coaches' insistence of keeping your core tight and straight, and then like your knees perfectly in alignment and your arm in perfect alignment and all this stuff, where no one actually talks about how there's like these spiral and bends of the movement, right? And so if you look here, pay attention to kind of like the order that things happen in, right? So the head is over the left foot. And then what happens is you kind of notice that as that foot plants, the head starts moving this way to the right. And then it actually, as he extends that foot all the way, you can see the hips are tilted this way and the head has moved over here. So now it's kind of like, it's kind of created a stretch across here, which if he sets up into his next stride to create a stretch across the other way. As his head goes here and that leg is here, the hip is tilted there, okay? So this is like Usain Bolt running, pretty fast runner. Now we got McDavid, and it's actually a very similar thing. It's kind of crazy. Where you see his head movement from here is over his left foot, then what happens is his head moves across. First I notice that his arms and shoulders open, and then his head moves across as he's pushing, so to speak. He's not actually pushing. It's more of like a really cool unwinding or twist of his body. And then again, his head moves over this way as he kind of uncoils that way. So really, really interesting to see. And I'm going to get into the off-ice drill in a second for you to see. But again, we'll go back. Now we'll see Nate MacKinnon, right? And you see the same thing, is that there is like a stretch here, right? Like there's like a coiling this way. Now his head moves over. You'll see his head move over, right? And you can kind of see how that body creates this bowing like this, and it loads up the other foot. And then again, the head moves this way, and then it goes to there. And you can see how his hips tilt on each stride. Like for example, right here, once his head goes, you can see how his hips are tilted this way, right? He's uncoiled, his head is that way. Then he kind of pushes the other way, and again, you see his hips tilt this way, his head's moved that way, and it's uncoiled that way. So it's just so, and again, you can see it here too, head comes out to one side, and it's creating that bowing of his body. And so it's just so the opposite of straight line pushes. It's like so far the opposite. And that's why it's interesting to look at the head movement. Now, you don't have to go about like, you know, aggressively moving your head or like totally reorganizing your training in this regard. But what you do want to do is you want to look and you want to like pay attention to, because what I noticed myself was like, oh, my head stays pretty still. And like when I start moving fast, I usually get really tense and have to push. So by adding in some head movement, you can actually start to feel the rhythm. And it so it's less about like you having the best head movement in the world. Let's leave that for ankles. Like let's really bring that microscopic focus to your ankles, and your Y angle and your shin angle and your crevice. Like let's have that level of attention to that. But this is super interesting for establishing your rhythm, right? And what we want to do is we want to play with some different ways of moving your body to feel what it's like to have your body uncoil and have a rhythm. So what I did was I did a couple little drills to focus on getting that feel of what it's like. And so what you can see here is I go from, this is like my stride foot, so to speak, right? My left foot. And this is like, you can really start to feel that as you move your head across this way, your body actually really wants to uncoil, your hips want to tilt, and you can actually kind of create that stretch across there. And you can see how the arm swing factors in naturally as well. And then again, you pay attention to like the head movement. The shoulders open first, I find, and then the head comes across. And then what ends up happening is the whole body uncoils, the hips tilt, you get that stretch across here, arms here, and then it really loads up and creates that stretch this way before twisting back and doing the exact same thing, right? So this is like again, it's like so the opposite of all the alignment and hold it tight, keep your core stable, all these things that you constantly hear about, but just are not actually happening in practice. And so, you know, there's the front view. I'll play it from the back view as well. So you can see, same thing, head movement. You can see the hip tilting. You can see the twisting, rotation, and bowing, right? And so what I mean is by this is that you can actually see how the body both rotates and like counter rotates, and there's like bowing like this. So like you're getting stretch across all your fascial lines or whatever you want to call that, right? Like you're creating that stretch. And then I also wanted to show it just from like a side angle as well, where like what it looks like for you to be here and then like spiraling into that step. So when you step, this is my head moving across, and you can see how really what's happening is everyone would call this like a stride. They're like, oh, it looks like he's pushing, right? They'd be like, it looks like he's pushing off his right leg, but really all I'm doing is twisting. And if we go back and look at our friend, our good friend Connor, or even let's start with Nathan MacKinnon, that's really what's happening here, is that twist. So he's from here, his head comes across, his arms come across, and he twists. And then same thing headed the other way. Is it's really like a twist and rotation. So I wanted to share this presentation with you just from, like I said, literally starting from here and taking what Babs was saying and looking at how much the head moves laterally and how that creates that and initiates that movement and that bowing in the body, and then taking that and saying, okay, you know, what does McDavid do, and does he do that? And he definitely does. And you know, what does MacKinnon do? And he definitely does that. And then paying attention to it myself and realizing, like, you know, I don't do that. So playing around with it on the sidewalk and you know, exploring that movement and adding that to my movement and feeling the ease with it. So something for you guys literally to play with. And you know, this can totally help with your rhythm in all your movements, and is only going to help your speed on straight ahead strides. So you know, you guys are going to be able to have a lot more ease with that as well. So anyway, thanks for watching this breakdown, and we will